I briefly introduced to you the GIA project, which is a joint project of the ADAPT Center of the University of Dublin, the Austrian Academy of Sciences, and the Europeana Local Service Center, Austria. The GIA project focuses on the access to and analysis of cultural images with new technology. And the project aims at analyzing the content of images using a combination of artificial intelligence tools and manual curation to present images with a more descriptive and representative controlled vocabulary. So we focus here on images rather than on text. The overall goals of the GIA project cover a broad spectrum. And as a starting point, the team defined the term cultural image as an image that depicts cultural artifacts, practices or social situations and placed research focus on food content in the images. And consequently, the research questions aim at answering how can we explicitly and semantically represent and interlink the rich information contained in the historical food images? How can we support efficient search, analysis, and exploit historical images by both humans and machines? And what artificial tools are available and how can we build AI tools for the exploitation of historical images? So we started by defining dedicated test sets from the wealth of image data available in the European Digital Cultural Library, the portal Europeana Collections. The Europeana portal contains about 32 million images. And through the GIA infrastructure, we searched and selected image sets that fit the GIA research purpose, like, for example, images that were marked as still life paintings. And in the next step, we analyzed the quality and richness of the existing metadata of the available images. And then we created the first data set and we tried different tools of artificial intelligence, commercial tools like Google Vision, Clarify, IBM Watson, and Microsoft Services, and one open source tool, YOLO, on the test data. And as a result of the metadata analysis, which was done as well, we selected two cultural art vocabularies, the Getty Arts and Architecture Thesaurus and the Icon Class vocabulary, and one food vocabulary, the food ontology. And these vocabularies form now our basis for enriching the content descriptions with food terms. And currently, we are finalizing the definitions of image classification, which will guide the next test cycle through human annotators and then be used to train a convolutional neural networks. I will now turn to the description of our collaboration experience. So our project brings together experts from the fields of digital humanities, semantic technologies, image aggregation, database and ontology construction, artificial intelligence and machine learning. Together, we are working on the creation of the experimental test sets and try to close the gap between the information backed in the images and the currently missing annotation of the content. This is the case because metadata generally most often describe the creator, the time, the genre, or the place of origin of a work of art, but often lack detailed descriptions of the actual image content. While the digital humanist examines the information contained in cultural images and selects the images, the image aggregation expert coordinates the creation of the image database with search, selection, and export functions. The machine learning expert then experiments with artificial intelligence tools and the retrieved test data. Finally, the expert for semantic technologies is specialized in knowledge presentation and the use of ontologies and thesauri for metadata enrichment. Our team is diverse in every aspect, in gender, education, and geography, and we see our weekly virtual meetings, our shared document platform, and joint publications as essential for smooth communication and work within the project, and hopefully for its later success. So, conclusion and recommendations. Being a professionally diverse team is an advantage because it helps us approach research from very different angles. We have found that the most important thing is to start with a solid digital humanities research question to understand the problem and to early define our own project terminology before moving on to a technical solution. It is also important to outline and discuss the technical requirements early to ensure that the digital humanities scholar will eventually be able to gather all the necessary information and participate in designing the most complete technical solution possibly at the end. So actually, it remains a fact that the picture will always say more than 1,000 words, but it's still worth trying to reveal more details about the content with the right tools, vocabulary, and question ask. So thank you.